Operation Luna.
BBC Radio 3 on VHF, 1215 kHz, 247 meters medium wave. Good morning, everyone. For today, Friday, the 4th of July, it's Patricia Hughes in London. In a few minutes.
Becker's revelations about his brief liaison in the cupboard of a London restaurant gets generous coverage in the tabloids and the broadsheets. The tennis star has given a no-holds-barred account of
Yes, I mean, he can speak a few actual words. Of course, it was extremely difficult to get him even to this stage. When I first captured Gerald in the Congo, I'm 67, I think it was.
68.
There was an awful lot of work to do. He was enormously slow and difficult. I had to do a lot of work with him on a sort of one-to-one basis.
If I might just butt in at this point, Tim, I think I should point out...
So one last question. You can look at these people here, widowers, whoever they are, and you can feel, I have no legal responsibility,
right,
and I've signed a piece of paper, and I have no moral responsibility either. Thank you. And it's not really the way to end a series, but it's the end of a series. Bye-bye.
Good evening and welcome once again to another session of Jukebox Jerry. I'm going to introduce The jury we have with us this session is a little different this week because we have two pairs, two married couples on our jury. The first two are very famous Danish recording stars whose records are constantly in our...
I've just lost my briefcase. I don't know, I'm asking you a question. Has anyone seen my briefcase? You see, I'm going to a party. I don't really need the briefcase. But I'm keeping it with me in case the party gets boring. Then I can go through some of my examination papers.
But there is another kind of sculpture that's private. And this would be an example. We've christened it Little Ray, with his rake. And I've tracked down the very first note to come to England. Here.
It's not only the views, it's the dreadful horse brassy pub run by rude jumped up shopkeepers in blazers and cravats. It's the bloody Regulus, backbone of England, and his lady wife, Mrs. Backbone of Necrolog. They're there to make the same entrance wherever they go. I presume they're rehearsing it as children. Then Mr. Backbone says,
oh,
and Mrs. Backbone says, then Mr. Backbone says,
what do you have, darling?
And Mrs. Backbone says,
oh yes, let's see, what shall I have?
And Mr. Backbone says,
why don't you have a whiskey